Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, it's worth rehearsing it.
That was good, isn't it?
First of all, we'll be talking about Selfie, which is brought to us by Blue Crown. It's Alex Pandrea and Simeon R. Stefan. And first of all, let's talk about the effect. What is the basic effect? What happens with Selfie? You're going in blind, you go and see your spectators, and you walk up to them. What happens, Sean?
Well, you walk up to them and you say, do you have a phone? First of all, you need a phone. It's just going to be like, you take their phone off them and you go into their camera and you talk about taking selfies. And you talk about how your camera and your phone, rather, is so attached and connected to you. If you're happy, you'll tell it that you're happy. If you're sad, you'll tell it that it's sad. And eventually you have empathy with this phone. So this phone knows how you feel. You're connected to this phone.
It's a nice bit of presentational patter that's explained on the DVD.
You then take a selfie of yourself, to get into the idea of talking about selfies. You then get them to hold their phone up, so they're about to take a selfie of themselves, and without them pressing the take picture button, you concentrate on it, and they concentrate on the moment when they want this selfie to happen.
The phone
goes, and it takes the picture
of them
on their phone. They can keep it, they can upload it to your Facebook wall, blah, blah, blah. And you know what? We did this we went to the pub earlier, and I did this on two girls, didn't I?
Hang on, yeah.
Are we jumping ahead of ourselves?
Yeah, let's talk about, first of all, on the DVD, you kind of get a live performance, but it's not kind of a complete live performance. You get half of a performance.
There's a bit of time misdirection that needs to be filled.
Yeah.
And what they don't give you live footage of on the DVD is the time misdirection. They tell you about the time misdirection, they tell you how to do it, but they don't give you live footage of them doing the time misdirection.
What we'd have liked, for a bit of guidance, is a full live performance from start to finish. And I think this kind of effect, this is very much a part of the method. And you want to see it working in real time.
Oh, well, that's the trick. And that is the trick, isn't
it?
Because we could almost prove that in the two ways that this happens.
We went to try it, like Sean said. Now, first of all, you went into this thinking, I'm not sure about this effect.
Yeah.
And I said, I think the reactions will surprise us.
Yeah.
We went and performed for a couple of ladies down at our local restaurant where we often have lunch. You did it. You did it faultlessly on this one with her phone, warmed her up with a card trick or two first. You then did the patter as described on the DVD. And the reaction, for a UK audience as well, the reaction was unbelievable, wasn't it?
They didn't just stare. They said, well done.
Yeah.
They went, well done, magic boy.
No, they were genuinely amazed.
They did.
And when we turned the camera off, they were still reacting to it.
And they were talking about it. They were actually shocked by this. This was a really strong piece of magic
and
with it.
As you pointed out, something we didn't discuss until we went and performed it, you actually said, can you share that on my Facebook page?
Blah, blah, blah.
You used it as a way for them to interact with you in the future.
I did.
Now
what happened is that, like you said, it was a flawless performance. Not by me, but by the method and everything.
Everything
it went
worked.
Really well. Everything didn't work the second time.
No.
It did work, but it didn't work.
You needed to kill a bit more time
because
with the setup, didn't you?
The time misdirection that I'd learnt from the DVD wasn't long enough for what actually happened.
So you needed to chat a bit more.
And therefore, there's a lot more chatting. It did get, because I wasn't expecting that, and then I didn't have a backup trick in place, and we really wanted to do this trick. I didn't have a way out. I had to just keep going to do this. So it did get a little bit long.
What
and a
kind
bit
of a
awkward.
Reaction did it get from the guy you did it on?
The guy I did, well, initially, they went, wow, that's amazing. And then, within like 30 seconds, somebody had gone, and we went,
is it this?
And he
actually guessed the method. One of the group guessed the method.
And when they have
away.
Guessed the method, can I say this? When they have guessed the method, they can then prove to themselves that they've got it right.
Well, yeah, there is a way on the DVD, as explained, where you can clean up from it,
But we didn't do that.
Probably our fault. But that's probably because it took so long to actually get into the effect. The reaction was still good, but they guessed the method. This is what I think about this.
Sorry, David, before you start your thing on it, I think, my theory on this is I think they only guessed the method because they could think back to the awkward bit. That makes sense. If it went as smoothly and swimmingly as we did on the ladies and it all just happened, then there was no like thing for them to think back and go, maybe something happened at that
You've
point.
You've got to be prepared for that to happen during your performance.
But so you need to work on something. So if it does take a little bit longer than it should, you've got something to fill the time.
Would you agree, if you're doing this casually, out and about, not for a big group, but for a couple of people, and it seems completely impromptu, Maybe when you're out on a night out or something like that, you haven't got anything with you, can I try something? It's got a better chance of getting a better reaction.
Oh, yeah, brilliant. Especially when people always believe in you. Because that's why we deliberately went and showed these girls and these guys a card trick first. So I think if we'd have gone up and said, here's a thing, I think they might have gone, well, maybe there's something dodgy going on here. But because they went, they bought into us as performers, they then liked it.
It got two very good reactions. The reaction surprises the first time would perhaps make me try it again on somebody, but I'm not sure I'm going to use it all the time. Certainly not as part of a professional set.
No, no.
How much are you going to give this?
This is a really tough one, so I really like the idea of it.
Go on,
really,
we've said all we got.
63%.
63. I was going to say 71, because I think the reaction would surprise you. You can only use it in a casual setting, but actually find the right person. Everybody's got a connection with selfies anyway. If you're doing magic making a selfie, they've got a chance of remembering you every time they take a selfie, and like you said, share it on my Facebook page. The marketing could go on and on. It's worth playing with a little bit more, but not as part of a big group with risk of exposure, I think. Hot footing it from the largest magic convention just round the corner at the youth club, where he's been signing new releases of his DVD. Jamie Docherty is here, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, Jamie. There we go. So, Jamie, let me get my notes. That's not obvious at all, is it? There we go. There's my notes.
I'm glad they were in order.
Right, first of all, you may have seen the trailer already. The trailer went live a couple of weeks ago now, wasn't it? This is for your effect, Transition. It was quite funny what happens. We'll put some clips up from the trailer on the screen. What happened when the trailer went live?
Okay, so this is the first...
Is your first release, isn't
it? Yeah. First thing, I'm completely new to the game with this, so my Facebook went absolutely mental. People like commenting, messaging, saying congratulations, it looks great, this, that, and it was great, it was really nice. And then there was people that were, we were talking about this earlier, how people were sort of like messaging on the, commenting on the actual trailer post and saying it was like camera tricks, it was this isn't real, it was fake, and we were like, whoa, that's an actual compliment, like, that's amazing.
People actually thought it was a camera trick, that we'd use video effects and that kind of thing. Obviously we just shot it, we shot you doing the moves as clearly as we possibly could.
And it's I think it's fair to say it looks...
You showed me. There's a couple of things.
Everybody's seen it here as well. You know which one
my favourite move is, right? Yeah. You showed me that and I went... That is what John said. Everyone's saying it's special effects. And I said it is special effects. It looks like a camera trick live. It's brilliant. That change, when that coin changes, just when you're turning it round, that's what magic should look like.
Yeah, you're just doing it and you left so clear. How long have you been working on Transition, the effect? How long have you been, because people sometimes work on things for months and that kind of thing. How long have you been working on this?
Well, it was about 2 years ago now.
Right.
I came to you guys and said this is an effect, and then you sort of worked on the gimmick and played around with it, and the transition gimmick was made.
Because you put a video up, didn't you? I remember you shared it on your Facebook. Yeah, dodgy video, just you in your front room, radiator in the background, we've all seen them, where you're kind of doing just coin moves and saying, what do you think? And some bits look good, some bits were okay. And then I kind of said to you, do you know what, if we actually create a gimmick to do this, so it was kind of sleight of hand free, because a lot of it didn't really use a gimmick to start with, it was just your skills. What happened when you started to add the gimmick to it?
Everything was just like really easy, everything was much more visual, because the gimmick does all the work for you.
Yeah.
Like, there's very little practice or anything. It just sort of made everything more visual.
What's your favourite effect? There's lots of effects that you do. I personally just like where you click and it just changes. I think that's fantastic.
But then there's some really clean things, other things, there's so many things.
You like the just turning it around, turning the coin around and the change. What is your favourite effect with it?
I like the coin through bag, because it's just, that is it. You have a coin, you have a bag.
And there's a clip on the trailer of you doing that live for some people, and their reaction, especially when you see the full performance of that, their reaction, they just can't handle it. The fact that they just see it pop into the bag, it really is incredibly clean, and then you hand the bag to them.
But they can examine it, yeah.
Your hands are empty at that point.
Hands are empty, the bag's sealed.
Unbelievable.
So if you were at a gig, where would you do it? Like, where, like, out with your mates at gigs, where would you do it?
It works in all situations. It's something that you can have once, I think it's fair to say there's a small bit of setup, but mm-hmm. once that initial 5 minutes is done,
do you have to do that every single time you use it?
No, not at all, no. So this can be in... Don't want to give too much away, yeah. but... So this
so it's
is
a one-time
you can
setup.
You can have with you however often you want. And
you set it up once, and when you set it up once...
How long does it take to set up the first time?
5 minutes.
5 minutes, and then from then on, you're ready to use it any time.
What about reset? Well, I mean, how long, you know, is there any reset to it? How long does that take?
The actual gimmick itself, no reset at all.
There you go.
And tell us a little bit about the gimmick without saying too much. They get a gimmick. What is
you actually
the gimmick?
Get two gimmicks. So you get the actual coin gimmick, and then which is real nicely made. And then you get a second part as well, which allows everything to be like real, allows the actual effect to be invisible and real visual.
So it's like
eliminates any possibility of the coin gimmick being seen.
So the coin, incredibly well made coin gimmick, and then the thing that makes the magic possible, which is obviously invisible, they can't see, which is what makes magic easy
so
to do.
So a couple of extra bits, gimmicks that you get as well as the actual coin as well.
What's the best reaction you've had from it?
The best reactions are, well, probably the silent ones, because it's just like...
Wow.
Just shock,
just
shock and all.
Trying to think about what actually just happened. Like.
And if you're watching this live at 12 o'clock on this Wednesday, the Wednesday that the show goes live, you're going to be doing this for Magicians Live on the Stand the Leamington Day of Magic today as well. So if you're watching this at 12 o'clock and you've not realised it's the Leamington Day of Magic and you don't live too far, get down there, because Jamie's going to be on the stand doing it all the time. It really does look as good live as it does in the trailer. Come and see it on the stand. Thank you very much for joining us.
No problem.
Jamie Docherty, the star of Transition.
Yes.
He's leaving the building to sign more autographs.
There we go. Ooh, it's connecting.
Under the shell, under the shell, under the shell. What is
under the shell?
There he is. It's Aaron, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, Aaron.
Right, okay. Aaron,
how are we doing?
There's the shells just there. But first of all, you've got to answer Your qualifying question, within 10 seconds, there's the timer. Sean's got the timer there.
Timer.
You've got to answer within 10 seconds. Are you ready, Aaron? You've got to name, within 10 seconds, three releases by Nicholas Lawrence.
When do I go?
What?
When do I go?
Now! You got 4 seconds left.
Something out of the ordinary.
10 seconds.
Chapswitch and split second.
He did it. It was our fault. We'll let you have that. Let you have it. All right. We're gonna be fair. We're gonna be fair. There you go. Say hello to him.
Hello.
There we go. Right. There's your three shells there. This is shell number one, shell number two, shell number three. Number one, number two, number three. Which one would you like to eliminate first? Sometime tonight.
Shell number one.
Shell number one.
Was that that one?
A
that
lot
one?
Of thought. That's shell number one.
You're
shell
going
number
to eliminate.
One. You would have won.
You would have won a mouse.
A mouse.
Squeak, squeak.
That's what you would have won. Right, okay. Which one would you like to eliminate next? Shell number two or shell number three?
Shell number three.
Eliminate number three.
He's eliminated.
I'm going to eliminate.
It would have been some monarchs with deck of cards. So would you have liked to have won that? He's not sure. There's a time delay. Satellite.
But you
right,
have won.
You have won. Da da da.
Completely mental. And Tiny Plunger.
Completely mental, Tiny Plunger. You are a winner at Under the Shell. We'll be in touch tomorrow to get your address and send those. First class recorded. So you can have those. Thank you for playing Under the Shell.
Under the Shell, Under the Shell. What is
Under the Shell?
Well, this next one's all your vault, John. It's time for special guest number two. It's David Penn.
Yay!
High five. Yeah.
See what I do?
Foxy does it as well, you see. High five. Yeah, you've got... Yeah. Good boy. Cover your eyes. Cover your eyes. Cover your eyes. Good boy. There we go. I can't beat that. That's better than the vault.
Yeah. Well, that's it for this week's Wizard Product Review. Right.
Yes, sure. Come on. It's a pleasure to be on the Wizard Product Review.
So tell me, David, about the vault. What is it?
It's that.
Well, and what does that do? Shall I just read off the back?
Yeah.
David Penn,
no,
the creator of Mystery... What's it?
They know all about that. Yeah. So what the vault is basically a device. It's a nest of boxes, which is a classic of magic, the nest of boxes, but it's attached to your key ring, so that your keys are left on the table throughout the performance, just like you're casually performing tricks for people. You get your keys out, you leave your keys there, you might leave your phone down, you borrow an object... like a ring or a signed coin, make it disappear in your favourite method. On the trailer and on the DVD, we show you how to do the coin fold with flash paper, and you throw your flash paper towards your bunch of keys with empty hands, and for the very first time, you pick up your keys. So, like a normal ring flight, you'd have to go to your pocket and go, my keys are in my pocket. You literally... say, I haven't touched my keys, there's my keys, attached to your keys is a box, inside that box is another box.
They can undo the box.
They can undo that. We were doing this earlier, showing you guys, inside that is another box, inside is the ring or the sign coin. That's what it is.
Now, you say about the flash paper.
Yeah.
Do you need the flash paper?
You don't need to use flash paper. You can use any method. It's just when Wayne and myself were filming the DVD, we wanted to give it that extra bit of production value. It is great to use the flash paper, but you can use any sort of coin banish. But I'll tell you what we'll do.
You ready for another question?
No, I was going to say, let's have a look at a full unedited performance. Ooh. So this is Wayne Fox actually performing it. You'll kind of, if you know about gimmicks and magic, you'll kind of see what's going on here. But it doesn't matter. We want you to see a full unedited performance of the vault. So it's over to Wayne Fox for a live performance.
And I'd like you to, if you don't mind, put your initials on it. Just so that we can clarify that is... put it round there, so let everyone see that you've done that as well. Well done, Jordan. And then turn it over for me. And do exactly the same thing, or perhaps put your initials on there as well.
Yep.
Everyone can see that. That's great, get rid of that. Okay.
Yep.
I'm gonna wrap this up in a bit of paper as well. And also, I'm gonna ask that you can see the imprint of the coin through the paper. Can you see? I mean, you can even hear that. Has anyone got a lighter?
Hang on a second, have
you got a light?
Oh, that's
right,
no.
You need to light that for me, if that's all right.
Yep.
Very closely, over here.
Okay. Oh my God.
That was a big flash, but it's okay.
Brilliant.
So let me, that coin's obviously vanished. Has anybody else got a pound coin I could borrow? No, I'm just kidding around. I don't know if you can notice this. My keys have been on there the whole time, and I've not touched them. Agreed?
No.
Yeah? They're right there. On there, you can see there's something there called a vault. You can get these. They're cash vaults. You can put money to save in there to keep it safe, and it's been on that keychain. If I just unscrew it for you, you can see inside it, there's another tiny box. Now, I'm gonna unscrew this one as well.
Yeah. another
and inside that there's of course another one as well.
Look at that.
And inside.
Oh my god.
I think I'm not gonna touch Jesus. Anything. I'm gonna tip that out. Is that the way you signed your name?
Yeah.
How has that got in there?
That's mad.
Give me some skin. Come on.
So obviously the nest of boxes, like you said, it's been around a long time, so people are going to go, oh, it's a nest of boxes. What makes this nest of boxes unique?
Well, the fact that most people, when they're using a nest of boxes effect, what they'll do is they'll put the coin somewhere mm-hmm. out of sight, and then the nest of boxes will get introduced at that point.
Yeah.
They'll bring them out of their pocket and go, oh, let's leave that box there. You can still feel the coin in the handkerchief.
Yeah.
Coin vanishers. Do you remember that nest of boxes?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what I tried to employ with this was like card under glass psychology.
Yeah.
And the best compliment I had was when I actually fooled Doc Eason with this. Because it is a bit similar to card under glass in the fact that when you do card under glass, they look back at the glass and it's there.
Yeah.
Now, with the nest of boxes, you're using the same psychology, but you're not using that as the effect.
It's like a camouflage version, isn't it?
Camouflage version of card, that's a perfect phrasing there, of card under glass to hide the fact that it might not have been there to start with, but when you draw attention to your keys and show it there, they assume that it's there attached to your keys.
Well, because it is there attached to your keys.
Attached to your keys. And you can confidently say to the spectator, now forget what we know what's going on as magicians, but as a performer, you can confidently say to your spectator, I haven't touched those keys.
Well, my keys have been there and down there the whole time.
Yeah.
You've seen that on the table.
I haven't touched
them. Blah, blah, blah.
And the fact that you can say that, I think that's what makes it unique as far as a ring flight effect goes and with regards to nest of boxes, because normally you have to bring it out, you have to handle it beforehand.
Absolutely.
This is hands off as far as they're concerned.
Now, let's say you were doing this table hopping or whatever, what's the reset like?
The reset, I've shown a few of the guys earlier this. People think it's going to be complicated, but as you actually tip the boxes out, you arrange them on the table in a row.
Right.
And then what happens is, as you're talking to them, you put them back together, you put one half of the boxes back in your pocket, and as you take the keys and put them away, just in that action, it takes a moment, you completely reset, aren't you? Completely reset to do it again.
Wonderful. So
It's out today.
Out today.
That's the vault. Once again, we'll be demoing this at the Leamington Day of Magic, or that unedited performance. And another one is actually on the Magic Cafe if you want to see two unedited performances.
Mm-hmm.
So that's The Vault, its latest release, out today. Next we've got from the creator of Reduction.
Ooh.
And Something Out of the Ordinary.
Yeah!
Nicholas Lawrence. He's getting to be a bit hit and miss, isn't he?
Hit and miss, it's like a game of darts, isn't it?
Yeah. It is. So, Chapswitch, first of all, talk about the effect, Sean. What is the effect with Chapswitch? Go into great detail here.
The effect is, I'm out with your mates and you're walking along.
With your chapstick?
And your mate says, can you show me? Can you show me? They say, hey, cool butch magician, can you show me a magic trick? And you say, hang on a minute. I've got a dollar bill or any currency will do throughout the world, worldwide currency. And you roll it up into a little tube. And then
don't you show your chapstick before this and put your chapstick in your pocket?
That's one presentation, yeah. You can do a swap process. Yeah. So you show your chapstick and you say you've got dry lips or whatever. And then there's gotta be motivation for it.
There has to be. Oh, my lips are dry.
I show you a magic trick? Hang on, before I show you the trick, my lips are a little bit dry. Hang on. Right.
I'll just put this in my pocket.
Now you want to see a magic trick, didn't you? Right. So I've got a banknote.
It's routine so well.
I think it's the way I'm explaining it. And then
I can't see that thread.
No.
I really can't.
What's really cool is you can't...
That's brilliant.
You can't see the banknote
that's
floating.
That's the good stuff.
Right, now, so you actually roll it up into a little tube, and then...
When the tube changes size, is that a
you
bonus
effect?
You
can't say that.
Oh, sorry. That's just what happens. I thought that was a bonus effect.
You're going to have to bleep that out.
Okay, we will.
So... You get the chapstick and
that's
you
a mouse.
You get the chapstick. You get the chapstick. You get the chapstick and you shake it and it changed.
Do that again. That was amazing.
You shake the chapstick, and it changes. No, the banknote. You shake the banknote, and it changes into a chapstick, and it actually swaps places with the one in your the note in your the chapstick that was in your pocket goes up here. The banknote goes down here into your pocket. The change place. It's very visual.
And then you take the lid off. And
you take the lid off.
Give
you do your
chapstick.
Lips. You give them the chapstick. They can try it out as well. Yeah,
check the note. Check the note, the note's fine.
Use somebody else's chapstick.
Yeah, no, they don't try it out, yeah.
They can
do. Right, what was the initial impression? We watched the routine.
I watched the DVD and went, wow, that's really visual. I had my concerns. My concerns were, it's a chapstick.
Yeah, meaning what? You don't carry chapsticks?
I don't carry chapsticks. My dad, to be fair, my dad does. So I mean, if my dad was a magician,
yeah,
this would be a good trick for him.
It is hard. There's this one unnatural bit in the routine.
He uses Reese's. You know, the peanut butter one.
No, I don't know. There is an unnatural bit in the routine where he kind of rolls it up and there's an awkward move and it's hard to
hide. It is
awkward.
And I think this is... there's better moves. I actually played with this, and I do a thing where I need to switch one pen for another pen in one of my routines, and I would do that move.
Yeah.
And it would work really well.
If you were performing in a live situation, you're nice and casual, it would probably fly as you were chatting and talking to people. The thing, I think what you've got to ask yourself is, do you want to be changing bills into chapsticks?
Well, the other thing as well, it's a throwaway moment. It's not a feature effect. And the guy on the DVD explained, Herman even says, you can't do this close up. You do need some more distance, otherwise the gimmick
might
be...
You've got to go back a bit.
And therefore, in my head, I have to question, is the effect powerful enough? No, well, I know the effect's strong, but is it the right type of effect where I'd create that situation where I'd have everybody standing there and it'd be like, right, I need to go back now and do this whole...
A little bit further back.
Yeah, but if you're doing that, it's because you're creating a bigger moment, I think. Yeah. Say, hey, everybody, stay there, check this out, I'm going back here, blah, blah, blah. Just to do a thing with a chapstick. That's my concern. But
as with all SansMinds things, the instructional DVD is very good. They say you get a gimmick. The gimmick's not custom made or anything like that. It's something that helps you to manufacture your own gimmick. It's a bit of an arts and crafts project. Not that long.
It's a five minute
job, but you've got a bit of an arts and crafts project to create your gimmick that will work with any chapstick pretty much.
And you can make more than one gimmick with what they've given you.
Yeah. The effect didn't excite me.
Yeah. It works, but it's a meh moment. It's like,
yeah,
meh.
You kind of, yeah, it's okay. I can't really say too much more about it. The gimmick works, but you'd be worried about using it in the real world. You're kind of a little bit disappointed when you get it because it's nothing clever. That moment works quite well, but I don't think it's something that you'll keep, you'll carry, you'll use again and again, like so many of the other releases that Nicholas Lawrence has brought us. This one is a bit of a miss as far as I'm concerned.
I know.
Is that fair to say?
How much
are you going to give it?
It's got to be like in the 50s, like 56.
Yeah, I'd give it 62%, a little bit more. I think it's one moment of visual magic. Might make a little Instagram video or something like that, but nothing more. Nothing more than that. It's not that strong an effect to use and warrant carrying the bits or even taking the time to make the gimmick up, as far as I'm concerned. That's it this week.
Whoa,
for
don't
the
do
Wizard Prodery.
I'm thinking I'm going home.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We've had some good stuff, we've had some bad stuff. Thanks for Jamie Docherty for joining us. If you're watching this now on your smartphone at the Leamington Day of Magic, come over and see us live in real life, because we're really there in person. You're not going to be there though, are you?
No, I'm busy.
You're in Liverpool. So we'll see you next week. Not next week. 2 weeks time.
You've got to get this right.
Sorry.
Every other week.
People tune in
and I've got to watch the same episode again.
Sorry. I'm sorry about that. That's it for this week's show. 2 weeks time. We'll see you again on the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time.
Yeah, well done. They did it without even asking.
Good boy. He knows we've got a business. We'll be right back.
isn't it? Yeah, it's there.